Hi everybody, this is Gaurav again. This video I am going over a basic overview of pharmaceutical world. There are many international candidates, there are many national candidates in United States, and this video apply to anybody who want to pursue a career in pharmaceutical world. In this video I will go over, or maybe this video apply to a bachelor degree candidate, a master degree candidate, a person who have any kind of experience and want to work in pharmaceutical company, a person who have a technical degree, a non-technical degree. In a nutshell, pharmaceutical experience or pharmaceutical world in a nutshell, so that you can make a judgment, you can make a decision, you can make a choice that if you want to land your career in this field or in this domain of the world, or whether to go for this type of roles or not. So let me quickly go over, as I always do in most of my videos, that I would like everybody to at least get an understanding or a visualization of what is a pharmaceutical company. This is completely through my knowledge and my experience. So I have taken this picture. This is a picture of a typical pharmaceutical company. Companies can be smaller in size, bigger in size, but a typical company looks like this. This has various offices. You can see that this is the company campus. A company campus consists of different buildings. You can see parking areas, you can see driving areas, you can see docks here where truck will come. And then they take the deliveries, they will go out, turn around, and go from here to the patient world by taking back the medications. So typically a pharmaceutical company consists of few more like common buildings, such as quality control department. This is quality control department. The responsibility of this department is to check the quality of each and every item coming into this whole campus, each and every item going outside this option, facility. This department, this company, or this quality control unit has a key role of checking every item coming in and every item coming or going out. Then we have office areas where, for example, quality assurance department, validation department, HR department, finance department, purchase department, warehouse department, supplier department, validation department, engineering department, regulatory affairs department, and other department, they sit in these buildings. Next, there is a raw material warehouse, and engineers, calibration team, and other teams sits in this building. Raw material warehouse is everything which will be used to produce a pharmaceutical product first will come in the raw material warehouse. From here it will go into manufacturing unit. So this central piece here has two parts. Manufacturing happen inside this, and also it has utilities area. So for example, in our house, you are aware that we have gas area, we have washing areas, we have drying areas, we have oil containers, we have burner area. Means we have a utility area where we have all the utilities which support day-to-day activities of our home operations, such as gas, hot water, heat, electricity, flooring, heating, or any other centralized air conditions. Similarly, to run this facility, you need some kind of utilities such as clean air, utilities such as energy, utilities such as steam, utilities such as gas, utilities such as oil, utilities such as solvents, nitrogen, compressed airs, because these all used in the manufacturing operation. So this second unit is manufacturing. The last one is finished warehouse, where all the finished pharmaceuticals or the finished item which are ready to be sell to patients, physician, hospitals, they are stored here. So you can see everything is segregated, have some distance. Every building has a dedicated title and unit operations. So I just first like to give everybody an overview that how a pharmaceutical company look like and what are the different department exist. So now we'll go to our next slide. In this slide, I have highlighted the different department exist in the company. If you go back, you will get to know that I have talked about some of these departments previously as well. So for example, quality assurance department, their responsibilities is pretty clear. They make sure that everything which is coming in or which is going out, as well as whatever we are manufacturing, is of standard quality. There is no quality compromise. Patient safety is first, and consistency in the process, so that we can repeat and produce the same product again and again and again. So that's this department help in that. Warehouse, as the name of this department indicate, this department helps in keeping raw materials and finished materials, also intermediate. Warehouse also maintain the inventory. Warehouse also maintain the temperature condition, shipment conditions, and all other temperature requirement or the storage requirement for different type of pharmaceutical products. Quality control, as I discussed in the previous slide, these have a very critical role. They control the quality of all the raw material coming in, which will be handled by raw material QC, and all the raw material or all the finished product which is going out by finished and stability quality control department. Manufacturing, as I suggested, manufacturing is the department which actually produce pharmaceuticals. Pharmaceuticals such as tablet, capsule, nasal spray, lozenges, and dry syrup, injections, parenterals, eye drops, everything is manufactured in this department. Regulatory affairs department. This department deals with the licensing, marketing authorization, approval, discussion with regulatory affairs authorities such as US FDA, EMA, TGA Australia. Process development department, as the name indicate, this department support the development of the process, removal of any challenges in the process, make a process robust, make a process so that it produce repetitively same results. Audit and compliance, this department make sure that whenever an audit comes from different agencies, we are in the compliance. Maintenance, utility, facility, metrology. You have a home, or if you are living in a home, you know that we need maintenance. We need utility support. We need facility support, metrology support. These departments help in running of overall the company. Manufacturing plants need help from utility department. Manufacturing plant need from the utility department, facility department, metrology department, and all these department help run the company smoothly. Validation, as the name indicate, this department make sure that every process, equipment, facility, utility, process, person, flow, training, everything is validated. Means you have a validated proof that operation is performed, and it is performed with a prior testing, and it has an ability to repeat itself consistently if you follow certain steps. Environment, health, and safety. This department makes sure that we are not hurting the environment, means everything we are doing is in compliance with the environment code. Health of people, health of patient, health of environment, and everything. Safety of people who are working in the company, safety of the patient world as well. So this is a department which deal with these things. Now let me tell you how pharmaceutical companies are work. These are basic principle, I can say that. So if you are planning to make a decision that you want to serve some pharmaceutical company, so here is something that you can take as a learning. For example, pharmaceutical companies follow guidance document by respective government authorities such as FDA, EMA for European Union, US FDA for United States, Canada have their authorities. Every authorities or government authorities write guidance document. These are 20 to 50 to 100 pages long documents that you need to follow in order to produce the pharmaceutical. So you have already set expectation from agencies before you send your product to the respective part of that world. Further, for United States, we have a federal regulations, 21 CFR, Code of Federal Regulations, and mentioned in these sections, you need to follow. If you are producing pharmaceutical, you have to follow this. You are following biologics, you have to follow this. If you are manufacturing medical device, follow these sections. Further, in pharmaceutical companies, everything is written. From entering in a company, to operate a machine, to release a product, or to do any operations. So don't feel that you need some kind of expertise. All operations are written. You need to just follow an operation, and you need to complete the number sequence of the steps, and you will find the same results and consistent quality and patient safety in every operations you do. So your thumb, rule of thumb in pharmaceutical company that work is, everything is written. You just need to follow instructions and you will be good. Then few more principles are, everything is done with a scientific evidence. Check, check, check. Three times. Like for example, if they establish the process. To establish the process that you need to do step number A, step number B, step number C, step number D. If they have written that, means they have scientific evidence for doing a step like that way. Also, if they did that, means they have checked it at least three times during validation. Done, check, and repeat. And they have the same results, and then they will write it down in standard operating procedures, and that's how you can see how pharmaceutical companies are following principles. Every machine, process, equipment, utility, facility, instrument are validated, calibrated, and repeated. Means all the process, equipment, utility, facility, and instrument, everything is calibrated, tested, and repeated. Further, if anything is not written, that operation never happened in pharmaceutical companies. So that's like a rule of thumb. In pharmaceutical companies, when you work, you need to write down every single thing. When it happened, how it happened, who did, what was the time, what was the date, and how, what else. Do what is written and write what you have done. These are some basic principles of pharmaceutical industry. So understanding or getting knowing about these principles will give you an idea that how disciplined this overall industry is. There is no margin of error, but at the same time, there is no like a rocket science. You need to follow principle, you need to follow guidance, you need to follow rules, you need to follow written instructions, and you will be safe. You will be safe enough to produce good products for patient world. Now, who can work in this industry? Pharmaceutical industry is good for people which are recent science graduate. Also, there are certain roles in different department where non-science graduates can work. For example, I shared, you can work in engineers, you can work as utility department, calibration department, facility department, metrology department, purchase department, sales department, supply chain department, HR department. Non-science people can also work in warehouse where they can they need minimum qualifications. Non-science people can work in the non-technical roles exist in the companies. For example, you can work as a training associate, you can work as a documentation associate, you can work as a data entry associate, you can work in IT department in supporting day-to-day activities, you can work in the environment and health or safety. One of these, you just need to know certain type of regulations and you will be good to start a career. People who have a bachelor degree in science and working in other industry, for example, you have a bachelor degree in science, now somehow you didn't get a chance to enter this industry, now it's the time you can make a choice after watching this video that maybe I can give a chance to be a part of this industry. So you can have a place and you can start working in this industry. Further, people who have interest in serving this industry, they are more than welcome to come. There are always a way. No matter you have a science graduate degrees, no matter you have a certain type of experience, no matter if you are working in a Dunkin' Donut or a non-technical field, you can still start your journey in this field. People who are okay to do contract jobs and small short-term and gain experience. What I want to say here is, there are some short-term projects, contract jobs available which may need or may not need certain type of experience. So if you are open to begin your journey with a short-term contract, this is the industry where you can jump in through a shortcut. So, and start gaining some experience here. Compensation. Let me talk about, this is completely of my own experience. Anybody can challenge me here, but I made an average of my own experience that, let's say if you are looking for a full-time job, and if you have a science degree, a bachelor degree, a master degree, associate degree, with no experience, you can easily start your career with a salary range of 45 to 65K with benefit and other bonuses. Let's say if you have you want to go for a full-time job with a people who have science degree, bachelor degree, master degree, and have an experience of 1 to 3 years in similar field, you can make it up to 65K to 85K with salary and bonus. Coming to contract jobs, you can make up to $18 to $26 if you have a science degree and no experience. With science degree and 2 to 3 years of experience, your salary range per hour is up to $45 per hour. But in contract jobs, there are no benefits. It's W-2. So you have to decide. Now, next is, what pharmaceutical company produce? What are the products? Like, for example, Microsoft make softwares, computers, Apple make iPhones, Netflix make content, YouTube make content, Google make marketing platforms. These are different companies and industry which are having their own products. So for pharmaceutical companies, the major products are can be understood through the dosage form designs and the route of administration. Don't get confused by dosage form design. It's just the different type of dose, means tablet, capsules, lozenges, nasal spray, eye drop, ear drop, tubes that you apply on your skins, creams, cosmetic, emulsion, suspension, syrups that you drink, injections, vaccines. These all are the dosage form, and we'll discuss further in the next slide. So this slide I took a source of this image is researchgate.net, and you can see their image here. I just copied their image for my information purpose. But let's see here. So to understand that what pharmaceutical company produce, it's very easy to just start thinking that how many type or how many route of administration of active drug inside our body. For example, we can take drug orally through our mouth. We can take drug through our eyes. We can take drug through our skin. We can take drug through our parenteral, means veins, injections. Those all comes in the vein form. So let's see oral. We have tablet, capsule, more different type of tablets, then gums, lozenges, solutions, suspension, emulsions, elixirs. So you can see these are the different type of dosage forms that pharmaceutical company will produce. Further, you can see for inhalation, sometimes we use dry powders to inhale. So those are the dry powder, dry drop in the nasal drops and nasal spray. For eye, you can use solution, emulsion, suspension, ointment, contact lens, implant, insert, and other things. So see, by looking at this slide, you can make an assumption that how many type of product are manufactured in pharmaceutical company. They are basically depend upon the route of administration, and they have their own categorization. So the end product of pharmaceutical companies are the drugs that are in a form of suitable doses form. Doses forms are tablet, capsules, injections, syrup, gel, foam, sponge, ointment, creams. So these. So you can see how different type of one important thing is to produce different category of product. There are different requirements of how a manufacturing company will look like. A manufacturing company will look like similar in all the cases except the condition in which products are manufactured. Next, I'm trying to give an overview of how many type of or across the globe there are different regulatory authorities exist. I'm not aware of many of them. I'm aware of only four. Indian authority, EMA for European Union, US FDA for United States, TGA Australia, I believe this is China FDA, and a few more authorities. So why I'm discussing these? In order to produce product for respective countries, you need to follow a guidance document issued by these regulatory authorities. As I mentioned previously in my first slide, that some principles exist in pharmaceutical companies, and those principles are here. Like for example, in order to sell products for United States, you need to follow guidance document posted by FDA, or you need to fulfill the requirement of code of federal regulations mentioned in the FDA or US code of federal regulations. Similarly apply to different countries. Now this is a typical flow of company inside the company. Particularly this is inside the manufacturing flow. Let me just jump into the manufacturing one. So I hope you understand this. Whatever I'm going to describe you now, it's happening inside this manufacturing and utility area, the central unit, manufacturing and utility, where the actual manufacturing operation is happening, where the actual drug is manufactured, where the actual pharmaceutical ingredients are manufactured. So let me show you that. So a typical manufacturing process, like if you enter in that manufacturing unit, first thing you will see a locker. Locker means you keep your personal item. For example, your keychain, your lunch box, your umbrella, and all other external utilities or external aids that you use on day-to-day life. For example, phone chargers, bag in case you have. Then you move next to a change room where you remove your street clothes and street shoes and wear company garments. When I say street shoes, means the shoes that you use in day-to-day life outside the world. Those shoes are contaminated, have dust, you have been to many areas, and then now you are coming to the company, so company want you to have clean shoes so that you don't bring the outside infections or outside dirt into the clean room companies, because we are manufacturing pharmaceuticals. So you change those here. Then you move to the next room, which is called gowning area. Gowning area is you wear another gown on the top of company gown, which is meant with which has a mask, a headgear, a shirt and a trouser, shoe cover, and glasses as well at some time. Now next is, the next room you go is document issuance. Like as I mentioned, do what is written and write what you have done. So company has areas where you get document issued. So quality assurance department is the department who is responsible for issuance of documents. So quality assurance department issue documents to manufacturing people or anybody who will be working on the in the manufacturing area. So what type of document they issue? They issue different type of documents such as SOP, such as protocol, such as specification, such as test data sheet, such as batch record, such as logbook, such as master document, such as label, such as checklist, area clearance form, or any other type of form which will be utilized on day-to-day activities. Material issuance form, packaging material issuance form, return form, destruction form, warehouse related request, everything you will get issued in this. So you collect, then you move further. When you move further, you issue raw material. Means, as I mentioned, if you remember the area, this area is very close to manufacturing area. You give the request that in order to produce a certain type of pharmaceuticals, and that we discussed above, for example, we may be producing tablets, we may be producing capsules, dry syrup, injections, solutions, suspensions, emulsions. So you issue the raw material from here. In a simple way, saying that if you are making a pasta, you need some raw ingredients, like you need pasta sauce, you need certain type of oils, dressings, cheese, veggies. So you issue those and then you move to the next room. Next room is a cold room where an active pharmaceutical is stored. Then you issue that. And remember, when you go to these next room, you have to perform operation and all the operations are recorded and written. Then you move to another room where label printing is happening. Then another room where packaging accessories are issued. Then everything is issued into this manufacturing line. So when I say manufacturing line, packaging floor, it's somewhere in this area. There may be multiple lines where different type of operations are happening. There may be one line. It's depend upon what type of company is, size of company is, where it is located, how many type of product it's manufacturing, how many different type of product it is producing, and how complex is the manufacturing process. Sometime it can be different based on how many different type of market they are serving, because some market has a different requirement. That if you are serving to Australia, please do not manufacture us on that floor. I am not sure if that's right, but I'm just saying that sometime to avoid mix up of medications, some companies has more than one lines. So then line operations happens here, series of steps performed, and at the end our pharmaceutical dosage forms is produced and we store that pharmaceutical dosage form in the warehouse. So you have seen the manufacturing flow, how it happened inside the company. Now I want to conclude this video. In the conclusion, I want to say pharmaceutical companies have higher growth because this is a recession proof job. I cannot say that, but it won't happen like all of a sudden all pharmaceutical companies are gone out of the market during a recession time. But they will be there because they have to produce drugs for the patient world who have certain disease conditions. Higher growth, why I said higher growth? With year, you will learn a lot of new skills. Those skills will give you more opportunity. Your salary will grow by the time, plus your bonus and benefit will help you survive up and down in your career. Helping patient world and a good cause, and you will get more blessings from the patient world if you are producing some key or rare disease drugs. With your skills grow, experience grow, your position also grow. So this is a small overview of what I think a pharmaceutical industry is. I will leave you guys with different type of doses form and an imagination of a company. Remember these principles we need to follow. Pharmaceutical company has a big backbone to follow the principle. Few important things is, if anything is not written in pharmaceutical company, that operation never happened. We have to perform, do what is written and write what you have done. Further, every operation has a scientific evidence and every operation is written. So you don't feel that if you don't have any kind of experience or you don't have a science background, because you don't need one. There is everything written and you just need to follow a set of instructions and you will be in the good hands. So remember, this is how a company look like. Pharmaceutical world, how they are working and what are their overall approach. Thank you so much.